activity 10, number 1.
Yeah.
It says a loan of 500,000 has taken out at an interest rate of 9% per annum, compounded monthly. It is repaid by equal monthly payments of 6,000 and a final payment less than 6,000. And then A, they say how many payments of 6,000 are needed to pay off the loan.
Yeah.
So we're going to use the present value annuity. Okay, so that one.
The present value annuity. Yeah, it says it's PV is.
That's one.
One.
One minus open minus. Bracket. Open bracket 1 plus i. To the power of minus n, close bracket, all over i.
All over i, ne?
Yes.
Okay. Karachi, now we're looking for what? N?
For n.
Okay. If we're looking for n, we can rearrange the formula and have the formula says minus n.
Is minus n is equal to log.
Log, ne?
Log.
Yeah.
Yes. 1 plus i.
Yeah.
And then 1 minus.
Yeah.
I multiply by PV all over I, X, I mean.
All over X, yes. Like this,
yes.
Okay, let's sup then and check which what is it that we're going to get. So we have
yes.
Log. Okay, Kana, what did we get? We got our X as 6,000.
Yes.
We got our PV.
PV as 500,000.
Okay, we got our interest.
As 0.09.
0.09. Divided yes. by 12.
By 12.
Okay. I think we are done. We have everything that we need.
Yes. So
we have the log. And then we have 1 plus 0.09 divided by 12, ne?
Yes.
And then we have 1 minus
0.09 over 12.
All over 12 multiplied by
500,000.
All over.
Over 6,000.
All over 6,000.
Yes.
Okay, and then we close our bracket and then we get our bracket. Minus n. Yeah, what is minus n?
Yes. It's 131.27.
It's minus 131.27. Okay.
Yes.
So the question is asking us about the number of payments. How many payments of 6,000?
6,000, so, yes.
How many payments are of 6,000 here? 131.27.
131.
Yeah, so the number of payments of 6,000 is going to be equaling to 131.
31.
Yeah, yes. Imagine like this one is 5 marks. This one, I know for sure. This one is going to be 5 marks. So you're going to be getting a mark for log. They give you a mark for the log. They give you a mark for substituting. Yeah, they give you a mark for simplification. And then this one, agree, you see this one, you made a conclusion to say of 6,000 is 131. They
yes.
to give you a mark for that.
Those were n equals to 131.
Yeah, yeah, you can check them there. It's correct. Okay, thank you. Let's get the next person to do this one. Outstanding. What's up? They say they want you.
F49.
Yeah? What's up? Yes. President, try it. And what did you get as N? We need the N here. We'll just write the N here.
131,
N is equaling to 131.27.
Yes.
Okay. President, what should I do here? I want to get the outstanding balance after the last payment of 6,000. So I have something like this. I have T0. T0. I have 131. T131. Then I want to get what is going to be the outstanding balance here. Eh?
Mm.
Yeah, what's still outstanding then it says N. Yes, President, N is.
N is 0,27.
Okay, N is going to be equaling to 0,27.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to use present value, which says PV is going to be equaling to 6,000. Open bracket, 1 minus.
Minus.
1 plus. Can we get what I is?
0,09
all over 12.
Yeah. Yeah.
To the power of minus 0,27. Close bracket. All over.
Yeah.
0,09 divided by 12. What did you get here, offense?
I didn't say 0,27.
You said what?
I got 0,26.
You got the rounding off. You should remember, you should round off the final answer. Né? You should round off at
yeah.
the end. Everything that you're doing, you round off at the end so that you don't make mistakes here.
Yeah, I see.
Okay, let's try. Anyone who used 0,27, can you give us the answer?
1,600.
It's 1,000.
1,033.
110.
12.
And 12, like this, comma. 0,33. Okay, sure. Okay, and then for a question like this one, they're going to give you 1 mark or 2 marks. Eh? If they want to, yeah, they're going to give you 1 and then 2, it can be 3, something like this.
See?
And then.
Mister.
Yes.
Mister, can you
0,27?
Yeah, that's a good question, right?
Mister, guys, 0,27. Mister, guys, 0,27.
Remember, here's what we got as an answer, eh? We got an answer as 131,27. Remember, ne? Then how many payments are we going to make of 6,000? 131.
Yes.
Then we make 131 payments of 6,000. But there's still this part here. If we take out the 131 here, what's going to remain? What's going to remain is 0,27, which is this part here. Excluding this, you're going. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
Sure. Okay, let's go to number C. Number C, they say, what is going to be the value of the final payment? Remember, we said if we want to get the value of the last payment, of the final payment, we're going to say, if we paid 831 here, we're going to pay this amount of 1,612.
Yes.
But we're not going to pay that. Now we're going to pay 832. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
That is the last payment. Mm-hmm. If they ask us how many payments we're going to make, we're going to make 132 payments. So we're going to have A, which is going to be 1,612, ne? Comma 33, open bracket, 1 plus 0,09 divided by 12. And then we just compound it. Always we compound it. The last payment we compound it only for
one month.
Yeah. And then what we get is our final answer.
1,624,42.
Yeah, and then they're going to give us 1, 2. A question like this one usually is going to give you 2 marks. Yes.
Question if you're going to 1,31,21,27, ratio 1,32.